Well, our heartiest thanks to each of our sponsors, ladies and gentlemen. Now, we will be moving on to our last panel discussion. That the topic is, will digital OOH, that is DOOH, drive the growth of OOH? And with the new innovation and programmatic approach, advertisers are more interested in digital signage and displays. What is next in DOOH is attract maximum eyeballs. Will this kill the traditional medium, that is the traditional media, after a few years? Well, that's what the question is. And I would like to now welcome our session chair, Mr. Sanket Rambia, MD and CEO, Extreme Media. Please put your hands together for Mr. Sanket Rambia. Sanket Rambia. Mr. Sanket established Extreme Media Private Limited in the year 2009 with a vision of reinventing digital display market in India. And Sanket is the first generation entrepreneur with deep passion for technology. He started Extreme Media with a team of two and now is leading a team of 50 young professionals. He has established Extreme Media as total solutions brand in digital display segment. Mr. Sanket envisions Extreme Media with establish India as the most cost-effective hub for software, hardware and content management in digital display technology solutions. So ladies and gentlemen, we have Mr. Sanket here with us already on the dais, and I would like to now call upon all my jury or the panelists. Well, we have Mr. Arun Gupta, CEO and founder, MO Magic Technology. Bhavna Mittal, Regional Head of Media, Digital and Communications. Rickett Benkiser, South Asia. Raghu Khanna, Founder and CEO, Cash Your Drive. Sarthak Seth, CMO, Panasonic India. Can we have a round of applause? Continue, please. Thank you. Shomitro Goswami, COO, Vioma Technologies Private Limited. And Winku Chakraborty, Business Head, Report India. Please put your hands together louder, ladies and gentlemen, for all our panelists. And now may we request Mr. Sanket to kindly take forward the session. Thank you.
Hi friends, are we fed now and tummies are full, or are we a little sleepy? We have a very interesting subject on our hands. I think we've been talking about digital in OOH forums for many years. I've been personally part of a few sessions in OAC and other forums, and we've been speaking about digital driving the OOH in future. But the question is, have we arrived yet? What are the challenges? What are the opportunities? What innovation can do to drive to OOH? We have a very interesting panel. We have panelists who represent the agency side. We have panelists who represent the brand side. We also have media owners. And we also have people like myself who are the technology providers for OOH. Small correction, we are not 150 people, we are 150 people now. So, having said that, let's dive into the discussion. We have a very short time, many questions. We have a very good panelist here. So, first question I would like to drive Winku. What are the trends in OOH and what is your experience in digital OOH?
Hi, Sanket.
Hello.
Am I audible?
Yes. A little louder, I think.
Hello. Is it better?
Yeah.
Okay. Couple of trends are there. First, I would like to start with some statistics, some numbers. So IPG Magna does some number crunching in terms of the total spends across the country, and digital as a percentage of the total out of home currently is only 3% in 2018. Mm-hmm. So digital out of home contributes to only 3% of the total out of home media mix. You know, though the number is less, but we have seen a very, I would say, aggressive uptake in the usage of this medium in all the plans that we roll out for different advertisers of ours. And though the, I would say, the look and feel of the different medium is very different, but there has been a big uptake across advertisers. It's not only restricted to one category per se, but across we have seen this. And also we have also seen the proliferation of digital screen across ambiences now, which has been very healthy, mm-hmm. especially in metro cities. So I would say these are two big trends that we have seen in digital.
So digital is growing at 25% CAGR.
Right.
But it's started with a very small base. It's still yeah. a very small portion of the entire right. out-of-home space.
Right.
So does it get the attention that it deserves?
No, it doesn't.
From the brand side?
No, it doesn't because, it doesn't actually because digital in India has to go a long way in terms of everything, in terms of where the placements are, the way it's getting packaged, the way it's getting sold, the way it's getting consumed by the brands. So I would say the entire ecosystem, every lever of the ecosystem has to work towards the growth of digital out of home, and we have a long way to go in out of home in India.
That's true for sure, that we have a long way to go. Bhavna, you represent the brand side. What's your take on digital?
I'm from an FMCG background here, and considering that most of our monies go into TV and TV still becomes the most cost effective media per se, by the time you reach thinking of, this is better? Yeah. Okay. So I'm saying for an FMCG brand like ours, we start with TV, you got to get onto digital as a media, and by the time you actually come to thinking about something like OOH and then digital OOH, your mind space is gone, your campaign is already on air, because as an advertiser, you typically see, okay, how can I reach the maximum number of people at the quickest, shortest time, and that's where the traditional media kind of come in. And also from a creative agency point of view, if you tell them that I need to launch this brand or I need to do this campaign, they would come back with a 30-second TVC, they would come back with a print ad, they would come back, but outdoor somewhere doesn't really become a part of the entire package, mm-hmm. right? And wherever it does, it is where you feel that you can use it more tactically, or something like, if I know that I have to do something in a city like Rai Bareilly, where I don't have an edition of a print edition and I just need to do something really specific there I might use outdoors. Even then, digital is still not there.
Right. Interesting. Bhavna, so example, a lot of your competitors like yourself use already TV commercials as a primary medium, or digital or print. If you want to stand out as a brand in minds of consumer, I think innovation is one thing that you can do much better in digital than any other medium.
True.
Have you explored any of, or as a brand, do you think this can be the way forward to make a unique impression in consumers' mind?
So absolutely, I think where we should focus on the media is where you can do something more contextual, something more relevant, and I mean, especially the medium itself leads to a lot more interactivity with the consumer, mm-hmm. which currently we are doing only on the mobile phones in terms of our digital campaigns.
Right.
Right? So if I can do something in a transit or an outdoor environment where I can actually get the consumers to interact with my ad and maybe get a real-time feedback, that's where it would really lead on to.
I think it could have a lasting impression as well if it's something unique, it's something...
Absolutely. I think absolutely. That's where, somewhere I think we as brands are also not focusing our minds and energies to think of what new and what extra can we do in these spaces. And there is a huge potential, but we are not, as of right now, we are not exploiting it. But again, you know, something like how digital as a media started. I'm saying, again, we typically were just putting our 30-second TVC onto a YouTube and saying, okay, we've done a digital plan, but how interactivity and all has gone up there. I think this media by itself leading to the measurement which is possible, the interactivity which is possible, the contextual targeting which is possible, is actually something which is waiting to explode.
Lots of things to explore yet in India for digital out of home for sure, I think. Shomitro, in digital out of home, I think the transit is the fastest growing medium. Can you throw some light on what's driving the growth in transit, and your take on digital DOOH.
Sure. So we're a digital out-of-home company, Vioma. We're in railway stations and metros. And we've chosen only to be in the transit location, so we'll be in toll plazas and buses next. And the reason we like it is, one is the numbers are very high, so the reach is a lot. Two is, it's very measurable in terms of the number of tickets bought or travelers on a bus or in a location, so it's helpful for the advertiser as well. And three, I think we can do a lot with that idle time that people have, either waiting at a ticket counter, waiting for a bus, waiting for a train. And we can sell them something that's unique to that time and space where they are sitting. So I think digital is not getting the growth that it should get because we're using it like out of home. We aren't using it like the digital medium that it is, right? And by that I mean people have said the word contextual, that makes a lot of sense. We can now do live information on our screens through APIs. We can do call to action using callback numbers and QR codes. We can do hyper-local information. And change those creatives on a daily, on a regular basis. So now we couldn't do that a year ago. Now if we can do those sorts of things in this transit location, we can actually be very targeted in the way we sell ads. And I think that's what makes this location very exciting for us.
So you spoke about exactly same things that the previous panel discussion was talking about, the problems of OOH, about measurement, about being contextual. I think these are the two problem areas for OOH which digital is able to solve, as per what you are saying.
I think so, and I think traditional OOH companies, or I think the industry in general says, take my still ad or my OOH ad and put it on a digital screen. And that's not the way to make the best use of the platform. And I think we have to change the mindset. I'll give you one example. There's a creative agency in the UK called Grand Visual. And they only do creatives for the digital out-of-home space. That's all they do. Now, if they found a business in this one medium and nothing else, that shows you sort of where the industry is going.
Wingo, I'll bring you in for just what he said. So what he said, we need to change the mindset of the agency, per se, who can drive the mindset of the brands, because I think agency needs to change the first before the brands can be changed. Brands' mindset can be changed. Are we seeing the specific content being made for digital OOH? And if not, is this what is also missing from the wide-scale adoption of digital OOH?
Sanket, you've asked too many questions in one question, so I will answer each question one by one. Just to add to what Shomitro said, how digital out-of-home would grow, it is not only dependent upon the mindset of the agencies or the way they sell it to the advertisers. It's basically, where are we in terms of digital out-of-home? First of all, I would say the biggest barrier that we have, not only in out-of-home, but digital out-of-home, is that there is no national regulation. I think it stems from there. That is the bedrock of all the problems. There has to be some consistency in terms of regulation. The moment there is a national regulator for, let's say, digital out-of-home per se, everything will fall into place. There would be, I would say, a systematic proliferation of out-of-home across cities, across tiers, and all of that. That is the bigger part of, I would say, digital out-of-home from a supplier perspective. Going back to agencies, I would say in all agencies and the way they deal with advertisers, digital is an integral part, and we have seen many advertisers customizing their digital creatives for digital placements. So they have invested in, I would say, customizing the creatives as per the ambiences. In fact, the advertisers are now going one step ahead, wherein they take out-of-home very, very seriously. Whether it is a pub or a bar or an airport vis-a-vis a beauty parlor, the communication is contextualized. It's no longer those, old days wherein the same TVC was displayed all across the screens. The times are changing now.
Sure. Raghu, you also are from the transit medium, but your form factor, your screens are much different. The audience size is also much different. What's your experience with this medium now?
See, the biggest challenge what we face is, how do we price the screens? Because that is a question which comes in the advertiser mind on the very first go. Whether we propose it as a CPM, cost per million basis, or we do on a cost per contact. So what we have tried doing it, because we are into the taxi advertising space, so we have put in the screens which are like smaller screens, 7 inches, 11 inches screens, which are more interactive. So we have gamified the concepts. So for one of the brands, what we have done, there was a sampling activity which needs to be conducted. So we had gamified with some questions where a TVC plays about the brand and the questions are asked depending on that TVC. And if someone answers that correctly, he gets an OTP on his cell phone and he's able to get a free sample along with it. So that is how we started up with the digital platform in the taxis. And we have seen that growing with the OTT coming in. We've done a fabulous campaign with Star. The whole idea is we are doing a digital sampling bit in it. So we don't say that we are advertising, we are saying we are giving you a digital sample. So what you are seeing in the taxi on the exterior of the car, be it a Netflix, be it a Amazon Prime, be it a Star TV campaign, that small commercial runs and then there's a contextual connect between the passenger who is sitting inside the taxi and who sees the advertising campaign on the exterior. So it is more of a connecting thing what we are trying to sell to the advertisers at this point of time.
Interesting. Arun, I think technology plays a very important role when it comes to digital out-of-home. That's one of the differentiators between the classic traditional OOH and the digital OOH. So what innovation can you bring on table which can actually expand the digital OOH footprint?
So I think from my point of view, from my company point of view, we are the one who are eagerly waiting for the OOH to really become digital OOH, because we are in the space of doing the data analytics, user profiling, and a lot of other things. So I think from my point of view, what we can bring to the table and what a technology can bring to the table is doing a lot of user profiling. Now there are a lot of technologies available worldwide who do the good face recognition, map the consumer, do the face ID, and by just doing the face ID, they can do a lot of user profiling. Like, let's say if you put something on a mall, you can identify who are your repeat user, who are your absconding users, who are your regular users. A lot of these things can be done. And now based on that, a lot of ad can be served to the consumer. Now, we can imagine in the future there is a billboard and on top of it there is a camera there, and based on the person who is looking at that billboard, the billboard change. I think similar things are happening on the TV based screens also. On a TV, there is a small camera there, and the way who is looking up to that TV, that change in that TV screens. And I think those technologies are getting slowly more and more mature. And as a technology company, probably these are some of those technology where we are working on, which we can bring to the table also. And I feel the way the OOH will really become a digital OOH, these kind of technologies will help, because the OOH means it will not the same hoarding which will get digitized. Probably a lot of new places will also emerge where the OOH will happen, and those will get digitized more easily. Yeah. This is my take.
Thank you. So,
can I just add to that? I think what's interesting about this is, if you look at all the pitches that we have done recently, and with agencies as well, the pitch is not about the reach anymore. We have the reach, we can explain that, and we can quantify it. It's about the demographic study, and it's about the innovation on the screen. So the pitch is not, you know, you can reach these people. It's what can I do with that reach, right? And only things that Arun is doing is very, only those kinds of things make it very easy for us to go to them and say, I can tell you exactly the kind of person standing in front of your screen at this point in time. And I can tell you the profile changes at 2 p.m. in the afternoon, and so do a different ad at that time of the day. Mm-hmm. Right? That kind of flexibility we didn't have before. Correct. And so you were saying that earlier, I think the dialogue is very different to what it was before, which is very interesting for us.
So what you're saying is you can bring context to your ads, where you are, what time of the day, how is the weather, and you can connect with the social media as well on digital. Interesting. So, you know, we have seen some of these in Times Square. You know, Times Square is all about digital out of home. Piccadilly, it's all about. When you see on television in Piccadilly, it's Piccadilly because of digital out of home. But we don't see anything remotely close to that in India. So what are the challenges? Why the adoption rate? We've been speaking about digital out of home for many years, I think, in OOH forums. You might be the witness of this. So what are the challenges in front of digital out of home? Would you like to chip in?
Well, Sanket, like talking about the challenges, the data itself says that, okay, it's still 3% of the total revenues or in terms of the industry contribution itself. So it speaks quite a lot as far as what is the availability or what is the total size right now. But again, the thing is from the infrastructure point of view also that, okay, what sort of infrastructure is actually available right now? And again, from the perspective that, okay, how much are the is the industry body able to push the particular format? Secondly, from the perspective of, I would say from the perspective of the corporations, the municipal corporations, how open they are to actually adapt to this media. So I would say when you talk from a broad, bigger formats, one interesting thing I would actually bring over here on this dais across with the audience. So it's not only about the creative, what we are actually talking over here, it is also about the reach, what he has just spoken about. But the thing is, as soon as you get into digital space, this also becomes one of your bigger enemies. Mm-hmm. Believe me, because as soon as you go to an advertiser or a brand and you talk about the, okay, I'm actually giving you this many number of reach, whether you talk from a CPM basis perspective or whatsoever, suddenly the brand also says that, okay, you have got a mobile, my digital advertising is anyway serving to the same consumer also. Mm-hmm. So it's pretty much on the pricing aspect, it is pretty much on the ROI basis also. So one really has to really chalk out a strategy saying that, okay, this is the best ROI what I can actually give it to you. Better things as far as this medium is concerned, I would say the most important thing is you can really do geo-targeting, what we're actually talking in terms of, can I change my creative at 2 p.m., 5 p.m., 8 p.m., depending upon the profile of the consumer who is traveling, or whether it is about that, okay, I just want to do this particular creative in Meerut as compared to a Delhi, which is going to be a different creative, and you can still control it at one location. So probably you yourselves are doing a lot of, I would say, solutions business with us as well.
Right.
And at the back end, you are able to control everything. Mm-hmm. That is where we have seen the industry is actually moving. Mm-hmm. So it's about that, okay, yes, you can do a lot of these things in controlled environment. When I say you will go inside a mall today, a lot of mediums are coming on the digital footprint. But when you talk from a bigger perspective, I really doubt we will actually be seeing a lot of outdoors, so to say, if we compare it to the Times Square or a Piccadilly Circus. So it's all about infrastructure, which is actually there right now available.
The infrastructure is not happening as per you because of the ROI. The ROI for...
Correct. So just tell me one thing, and most of the media owners are also sitting. So today I say that, okay, let me go out and digitize the entire 6 metro spaces. Mm-hmm. As any of the media owners or the asset owners over here. If we say that, okay, let's put across 25 different hoardings in these 25, in these 6 cities, what is going to be the total investment, what is actually needed? Is somebody actually putting that particular thing at one go and saying that, okay, this is how I'm going to actually provide you with the ROI? From a perspective, the amount of money as far as the capex is concerned, is somebody ready to invest that much amount of money? Mm-hmm. So these are certain things which we really also need to deliberate on.
So if you see trends, you know, in across the world, digital is not just hoarding, big hoardings, but that transit is the medium. But I think digital hoardings get the maximum mind space when it comes to brands, because those are the most visible aspects of out of home. So if you look at New Zealand, you know, it's a very small country, but in New Zealand, I've been personally, when I went there, I saw like 70-80% of the out-of-home hoardings were digital.
So again, the thing is the infrastructure over there, in terms of, I would also say that, okay, how much the government bodies are really taking interest in terms of beautification, in terms of regularizing all of these things. Also, another perspective is that, okay, because, see, it also depends from brand to brand, where exactly they want to invest. So suppose if I say that, okay, as a strategy, I really want to expand my network into tier 2, tier 3, tier 4 cities in India. Now, how many digital OOH are actually available over there? Very few. Or probably I can say none, so to say. So what is the best available option if I have to actually go to a OOH? It's the static ones, what you have. Secondly, even if I look at it from a perspective that, okay, because in our business, what matters quite a lot is how the trade partner is actually behaving in terms of what the trade partner requires. So if I have to look into a 2-kilometer periphery, what is the option available? It's again a static out of home. Mm-hmm. And then if I have to go onto a digital media, I would say then it actually becomes a mobile phone. So it is again the thing that somewhere mobile phone is also like obviously you just cannot categorize it as a out of home, but from a digital standpoint, it is also delivering the same message. Mobile phone also, you can actually do the geo-targeting. So you can really reach out to the end consumer from there also. So it is all about how we are able to define a ROI from the perspective going to a brand and offering him or her X solution, saying that, okay, this is what we are actually there to bring on the table.
Vinku, we spoke on phone and, you know, I think, and also I did some research online, what we see overseas is like 50 to 60% of out of home spend is on digital. Is this data somewhere correct?
Yeah. Around 2/3 of the total is on digital. So it varies from across, I would say, country to country, but on average, you can take a level of around 24% as a global average, according to Magna reports.
So 24% of global average.
Right.
And somebody like UK or US would be around 50 to 60%.
They're a little higher.
Yeah, much higher. And we are at 3%.
Yeah.
So there is a huge room for improvement. And no matter what, one thing I'm a strong believer in, you cannot fight technology. You know, you can form regulations, but Uber came, regulators could not do anything, even though they wanted to protect the fleet taxis or traditional taxis. So you cannot fight technology. So adoption will happen today or tomorrow. It's just a matter of time. Is this statement too strong, or you think we are somewhere there?
I would say it's a statement in the right direction. We not only have to adopt, we have to embrace technology, because technology is the way forward. And I would like to add what Sarthak said. Digital, in fact, digital out of home works beautifully with social and with mobile. Mm-hmm. I would just quote a smaller case study that Rapo UK did an experiment in UK, wherein they deployed a media mix of mobile video ads along with digital out of home. Out of that test, what came out was that the CTR for mobile video ad, you know, jumps 200% more if it is deployed in sync with digital out of home. So that's right. A beautiful insight that came out of over there. And I would say digital, mobile, and social are good friends. They have to work in sync, and that's how the media mixes would be created for the future in India as well.
I would just like to add to one thing, which I think we're missing out, is that digital out of home will give us a measurability angle which currently a lot of us find missing in the traditional OOH. We
spoke about it in the previous, yeah.
Okay, so that's the exam. Big thing. And again, considering as a large advertiser, you are constantly questioned by the finance guys to tell you where is it being monitored and all those reports and audit reports which are required. Suddenly you know that there is something which is actually measurable, you know it's happening, and hopefully we will get real-time analytics out of it as well.
Yeah, I think what I saw in some of the case studies in UK, you could actually see not just how many people, but male, female, age, gender, the emotions, even they could see, measure or count the cars, the type of cars, like how many sedans, how many SUVs, luxury cars. So if this kind of data is available to you, would you think you will have better
Yeah, then it actually ROI. Tells me why I should be putting my my creative out in the open, and exactly what should I be saying, to whom should I be targeting, and at what time, what is working. So that would really give us a lot of things to think about, and then, you know, it will give the excitement around the media as well, because you would want to try out new things.
Yeah, Shomindra, you have something to add?
I just want to add to what people are saying regarding the cost and things, right? We're a company with only digital assets. We will actually never do OOH assets, traditional ones, because we're in a different direction. I think there's a space, there's room for everything. But cost of technology is coming down quite drastically, and we will be very selective. So we will only go into places, say a tier one town or a big location or a Times Square-like location where you can put a digital asset because you can actually monetize it better. But I think overall the move is in that direction. So to what Bhavna is saying, I think, you know, it's more measurable. You can do a lot more with that data. So this 50% number has to come to India from 3%, right, in terms of digital out of home to out of home. And so I think that transition is going to happen. And most companies will start adding more digital assets as it becomes less expensive to do so. Maybe in select locations, but they will start doing that.
Sure. Well, even just to add to his point, there's another reason why a lot of companies would really look forward, because it is, again, I would say, there's a certain degree of premiumness also when you actually go to such mediums for any brand whosoever wants to really advertise. So even from the media selection standpoint, if a brand is actually seeing a premium, why not? The only is to what degree. So that's the only thing. So definitely I agree that the cost of technology over a period of time is going to come down. It's only about that, okay, whether it is going to happen in next 6 months or whether it's going to happen in next 3 years. So
I think I want to add one thing, because the moment the technology comes, the most important point which probably Vinku has raised in the beginning to solve is we have to have a national policy to handle OOH, because the moment we bring technology in, you can't do corporation to corporation change. It has to be at national level, otherwise it won't work.
Yeah, so national policy for digital out of home is, or out of home in general, I feel it's too fragmented. Every municipality have their own regulations and they keep changing all the time. And that's one of the, I think, major problem areas for out of home in general. Let's talk about innovation and any, how innovation has driven digital in India or outside. So, Soumitra, if you would like to throw some light on what your company has done in innovation space, in technology space, to stand out from traditional OOH.
I can give two quick examples. Google did a campaign with us, and somebody mentioned Google in an earlier panel. As you know, they have RailWire, they have Google internet access in the railway stations now, and they want people to get online. So on our screens, the first month, they did a normal campaign where they branded branding. And on the second month, they had live information streaming through an API. So right now, this song is trending on YouTube, right? They gave that information. And they want people to actually log into the Wi-Fi and then go watch that song or download that song. So that's a company using the innovation very effectively. Mm-hmm. TVS did a campaign with us where they gave away 5 TVS Victor bikes. And then so you call back a number on the screen, because that's more effective today in India than, say, a QR code. You call back a number, you get a link, an SMS, you click on that link, and then you enter the lucky draw, right? So not only did they give away the 5 bikes and build credibility and all of that, but they also got, now we have data on these thousands of people who've actually responded, and we know what their search histories are like, you know, what kind of information they are looking at on their phone, what kind of phones they have, what kind of products they use. And that's a very useful thing, not only for TVS, but for any other client that we'll have, and we'll go back to them and say, we know the demographic of the person in this location who's actually logged into this campaign, right? So that's actually a very nice way to bridge this data gap and the technology gap.
Very nice. Meghna, you shared one interesting case study, Bhavna, you shared a very interesting case study with me earlier. About innovation that happened internationally. Would you
know? Yes. Sanket, this was, and today being International Women's Day, I think one case study which I saw somewhere on the net, somebody shared it on Facebook, was on domestic violence. And this was, again, UK. We seem to be taking UK's name a lot. So there was this huge, large hoarding which had a woman with a lot of bruises on her face. And the moment somebody saw it, the bruises started diminishing. And as Arun was mentioning earlier, there was a camera on top of the hoarding. So if you were seeing the hoarding, you could actually see your face in a scroll below. And as more and more people started looking at it, the bruises started going down and it came back to a normal face. And the message was that, you know, you need to talk about it. The more people talk about it and stop hiding it, the better it will be for people to actually understand that this is happening. And what they also did was a bit of a polygon targeting around that the person who was watching it would get an SMS or a code in their mobiles at around the same time, which actually asked them to make a donation towards Women Aid. And I thought it was a brilliant example of how something so prevalent and something which is completely not talked about could be brought out in the open and made such a important and effective message.
And it did the job and it had a lasting impression.
Absolutely.
Which
absolutely
you could not have got using other mediums maybe.
Absolutely, because people don't talk about it. I mean, there are stats which say 2 out of 3 women have actually suffered something in that market. But
subject was also very touchy, but I think the brands can also use some innovation to have a lasting impression.
Absolutely. I think we just need to think our minds and say what different can we do and how can we use this effectively so that even one holding of one screen somewhere actually is a job well done.
And as a technology provider, I can say that the technology that requires to do this kind of campaign exists in India very much. It's very cost effective and it's not at all at an experimental stage. Mm-hmm. It's just the willingness to do it is what is lacking maybe, and obviously the other challenges of regulation and other aspects.
I think, I mean, point well made. It's just that we as advertisers or brands need to think what we want to do different and which is what we are currently a bit maybe away from. We leave it to the creative agencies or we don't challenge our creative agencies enough to really think and say that what can we do more on this.
I mean,
this
sometimes we need to maybe think out of ROI for
absolutely
a change.
Yeah, very true, very true. Yeah.
Maybe. I'm an outsider, so you can pardon me. Any other interesting case studies anyone, any of you want to share?
We recently did a similar activity in Kumbh. So we had a LED screen and we had a technology which had coin sensors. So the concept was for Marico. And the idea was there was a image which was there and slowly and steadily it was keep on changing as soon as people were putting a donation. It was for a woman, it was for a girl studying NGO. So it was Punya Ki Dukki campaign. So anyone who comes out of the Snan area puts in a coin and the image immediately flicks out. And after a complete collection of around 1080 pixels, the number of pixels which are there in the screen, it turns out to be a girl child studying. So that was the recent one which we did in the Kumbh.
It was well received.
Yeah, well received. Well received.
One more, somebody wants to share, or because we're running out of time, I'll conclude. Anyone wants to share anything else other than what we have covered so far? Anything else? All right. So it was a very interesting conversation. Thank you, everyone. I will quickly summarize what we discussed. I think 3% market share in India for digital out of home versus 24% overall in the world. So there is a big gap which needs to be filled. Technology can play its part, innovation can play its part. Obviously, there are challenges in terms of regulation, market fragmentation, lack of ROI data, and obviously the scarcity of vibrant spaces like Piccadilly or Times OH. But I think have we arrived? No, I think definitely not, but the journey has definitely begun. I think all of you would agree on that statement. With that, I throw the floor open to the audience if you have any questions for our panelists.
Questions can be taken offline if, please. Only one question can be taken, yeah? We have time. Okay, so we have gentlemen here in the middle. There. Great.
I'm Mani from Armor. I think last 1.5 years, a lot of these panel discussions are happening into transition from OOH to digital OOH. And we are all seeing growing trends from the brands, from the media owners. One thing which I would like to point out is the expectation from the media fraternity, from the brand owners is very high. It's good. Media owners are also stepping up in terms of investment and in terms of taking responsibility. But when the brand wants an ROI, the media owner also wants an ROI. Is there a position where the brands can take, okay, from at least 8 out of the 10 campaigns in a year, some percentage should be allotted to OH, some percentage for DOH. If this works, it gives a lot of encouragement for the media owners to invest more. What is happening is, in our pyramid, the pyramid is reversed. The OH budgets are the lowest, and then the expectation is very high. I mean, very realistic, true situation. So it's a request that the support we get, we will be encouraged to do more. We want to move ahead, we want to progress. Nice UK, US figures are 50%, we are at 3%. How do we reach that target? We are ready to do it. Let's shake hands together.
Yeah. Is there a question?
It's a suggestion. It's a suggestion. Yeah.
Thank you. Thanks.
Wonderful.
I think.
Thank you so much. And thanks to Mr. Sanket here for being such a great moderator. And now let me call upon Manish Sethi. Mr. Manish Sethi, Director, EG Communications Private Limited, to please come forward and give away the mementos to all our esteemed panelists. So please, maybe have Mr. Manish Sethi here. This was such a wonderful session, and this is the end of the panel discussion, ladies and gentlemen, the final panel discussion we had, and a lot of insights about OOH and of course the DOOH, how it is going to impact our future strategies and of course the business, so which is very, very important learning. And here there are so many insights, and definitely we have a bright future ahead in the domain of DOOH and of course at OOH as well. So ladies and gentlemen, I would now like to request the panel